real flick. Do you hear that? It's the blessed sound of radio silence, which leads me to believe you have sweet, sweet news for me. Yes, indeed. I am back in business. But before we get down to it, might I ask how you handled the problem in the end?
Come on, do you really want to get invested in the details? We finished the job.
Is that so? I don't know how. The two are diametrically opposed and impossible to please. But it matters not how you fixed my problem, only that you did. I don't doubt that you are working with Phineas, but my contract specifies I relay any acquired information to the purchaser, and to the purchaser alone. However, to send the data, I will need your assistance in cycling the antenna's receiver so I can input the needed adjustments. You make it sound so scandalous. Phineas has been in hiding for the past 35 years. He got in touch with Neoka first, who I use as a physical go-between. The rest is history. It's simple, truly. I merely need you to waltz outside and throw the lever to cycle the power. I'll key in the numerical adjustments from in here. Eternal, no. What is wrong with you? Who would ever design something like that? However, you're welcome to brew me a Rizzo Insta-coffee from the staff kitchen on your way back. Just step outside, flip the switch, depart forever. Understood? Good. Marvelous. We're in agreement.
If that's really all, let's just get it done with and be on our way.
Terrific. I'll be here. Waiting with bated breath. Give a shout if the panel electrocutes you.
check. Sweet stars. But that is a beautiful sound. Can you hear me? We are a go for broadcast. Oh, and I also dispatched Phineas his data. Impatient prick. Worse, I'm now indebted to him for it. Now I'll kindly thank you to get out of my tower. Look, I am well aware that at times I may have the tiniest iota of a prickly exterior, but I must admit I have grown rather fond of you. Take care out there.
Captain! Big flaming thingy!
Black holes! Did you see that? Looked like a UDL ship. Based on the gunnery attachments, I guess it's one of the board's blockade enforcers, but don't cite me on that. Oh well, a pity for the crew, but I can't see how it affects me.
Hiram? Can you hear me? Did you see that?
Architect, save me from swindlers and fools. Sanjar! What are you bloody doing on my channel? Did MSI or did MSI not cease broadcasting?
Yes, but...
Hiram! Hiram, are you there?
Not without a physical contact waiver.
Ah, the good captain. The truth brings us together once more. Our salvation has come crashing through the stratosphere. We need only collect its weapons.
Are you mad? That's a UDL gunship. You'd probably shoot your own toes off.
Ah, I see you learned nothing while dealing with these buffoons.
We could use the gunship's armaments to defend Stellar Bay, but we need its targeting module.
Our message is so close to breaking free of this planet and spreading to the stars. Help us secure that module, and we will save our colony.
Listen, I don't care a single whit what you do, so long as you leave me out of it. Which means, get off my void damn channel! I'm more than finished with you lot.
daughter is a dead or dying. Slick work in there.
Isn't it? Nice views, a little exercise and fresh air. Well, and sulfury, spory air.
Take a hint.
Hey.
I'm going. Take real good care of your pistol, Dr. Fenhill.
I oughta. Kept me alive this long.
I mean, you treat it nice. Makes me happy to see, because I feel the same way about my wrench.
Look, it's a tool that does a job. Feeling's got nothing to do with it.
On my way. No problem. The smell here is 100% off.
You sure have seen a lot of the colony, huh, Dr. Fenhill?
Ellie. And sure, but most of it looks the same from inside a ship.
Sorry, Dr. Ellie. Still, though, don't you find it thrilling, being in space?
Look, it's just Ellie.
Again? You want to buy something?
You seen Arthur today?
I don't think I like Miss Catherine. Not just on account of the swearing, though she swears awful much.
So tell me, do we drink to the damage you've done? Or will I want to smash this bottle over your head? Sure.
Puts a damper on the mood.
Oh, that's just Miss Malin working on some fella. I heard sometimes when the tunnels get infested, she feeds them to the manta queens. Pretty gruesome way to go.